don't understand it, right?
Okay, so, you know there's gonna be, these graphs are gonna be lines, okay? To find a line, we need how many points, so fewest number of points we could find and be able to draw that line.
Plug in 0 for
x. I'm asking a question about how many points do we need? What's the fewest number of points we could find?
Two.
Okay, find two. Now it comes down to which two, and the first one, the easiest one.
Zero.
Plug 0 in for x.
And then isn't that 1/4?
What would it give us if we plug 0 in here?
Zero.
Zero
times 1/4 is 0 plus, there's nothing there, so it's 0. 0, 0. All right, and we're welcome to plug any number we wanted for x, but 4 would be much easier. Right. We got 4 times 1, 4. 4 times 1, 4. It's 4 over 4 is 1. 4 over 1. And I will remind you that we're kind of starting to see this pattern. Every time I move over 4, I'm going to move up 1.
Oh, yeah.
Over 4. So if I move over another 4, another 1, another 4, which takes me kind of off the chart here. 1. And there it is. I could go back 2, I could go back 4, down 1. I could continue that line in that direction, but we've already found 2 points more than we need to find.
It's pretty easy. That was a good one.
So we've got that pattern of every time we move over 4, this is the thing that I want you to keep in mind. I don't want you to just memorize patterns and forget what it all means. The reason why we move over 4 is because 4 is the number that cancels out this denominator of 4. And we move over 8, 8 will be canceled by 4, and 12, and so on and so on. Okay, next we have 10. What's a point that we can find really, really quickly and easily?
0, -1.
-1, put a 0 in for x, -1 is what comes out. Now this one might almost seem a little bit tricky because usually we say like, oh, I look at the fraction and find the denominator, but there is no denominator.
I just put down 1 since there was no fraction.
So there is no denominator to try and cancel out. Okay, so we plug a 1 in there for x. We could do it in our heads, or we could just quickly jot it down if we want to be sure we don't make any mistakes. We get -7 - 1, and we have -8. Right? This is -7/1. You could look at it like that. And every time we move over 1, we move up. How much do we move up?
7. 6.
Move up 7?
-7.
We move up -7, which is actually to move down. Right? So we move over 1. And we move down 7, which puts us at -8/1, down 7. Right? It's like making, like spending $7 every hour. Right? Like maybe you're renting some rototiller or something from a place and it costs $7 an hour. And every hour that goes by, your money decreases by 7. Another hour, another $7 is gone, right? You're losing money. We have what we call a negative rate of change. We have a negative rate of change, 7. So our, put it another way, our change in y versus change in x, our x changes 1 and our y changes -7, which is the same as our y changing -1 and our x changing -1 and our y changing +7. forward one and down seven. We can go backward one. That's a negative one there. Backward one and up seven. And that should be this, yeah, right there. Up six. Next is 12. So what's the point that we can find? Plug in
zero.
Tim?
Zero.
Zero for x, that gives us what for y, Tim?
Negative
1/2. Zero minus 1/2. So our point is that 0 -1/2. Can manage that. What number would you choose to plug in for x? Next, Bridger?
4.
4. Now if I plug in 4, I'm going to get a 4 canceling the 4, which leaves a 3, right? So we're going to add a 3 and a negative 1/2. We're going to take 3 and subtract 1/2, which leaves us with how much?
2.5.
2.5, 2.5. So 4, right, means we can look at it this way too. We move over 1, 2, 3, 4, still right here, negative 1/2. Then you can move up. 3 from there, 1, 2, 3, there we are.
Oh, that makes sense.
And we have 2 points that are part of the line, finish the line. And when I draw the line, what is it I'm really drawing?
The pattern.
Infinite amount of dots
following that pattern, guessing where the rest of those points are going to be, all infinity of them. And 2.2. What do we do here? We've got this point that shows us that negative 4, 1. And it even tells us that. It writes the coordinates for us. Another point that belongs to this line is at 1, negative 2. So, this is a good, we did this quickly at the end of the class, so let's do it less quickly now. Find the slope that this line has. Rate of change of this line. Let's just review these last three lines that we've done. Remember, we had a 1/4 times x. Well, we moved over 4 and up 1. Over 4 and up 1. Well, we had a negative 7 times x, a negative 7 over 1. Every time we moved over 1 to the right, we moved down 7. Here, every time we moved to the right 4, what did we move?
3.
Up 3. Up 3. Right, that's the pattern. Moving over the denominator, moving up the numerator. If the numerator or denominator is negative, then right, that means that we move in the opposite direction.
So, you know, on these kind of problems, like when you're trying to find a function, like a point on the graph,
mm-hmm.
Could you times it, like plug in x as 3/4?
Yeah, you could. Well, 3/4. 3/4 are going to be 9/16. What about 4/3 though?
So then it will 1?
Right. Yeah, 4/3 would give me a 12 over 12. The only thing about that is now the reason why we're plugging in values for x, that we're selecting those values is because we want to try and get y to not have fractions in it. But if we plug in 4/3 for x, now x has a fraction. But plugging in 4/3 does make the result, which is more occasional, a little easier to deal with. And let's look on the line. If we can plug in 4/3, here's 1, 2, 3/3. There's 4/3 right there. There's 4/3. So I plug 4/3 in there. 4/3 times 3/4 is what?
1.
1. 1. Minus 1/2. What's 1 minus 1/2?
-1/2.
1?
Or 1/2.
1/2. Yeah, 1 is bigger than 1/2, and 1 minus 1/2 just leaves 1/2. So if we look there at 4/3, right about there, and we go up to, there's it look like the points at 1/2?
Yeah.
So it does.
Look like it.
Not perfect, but
it looks very close. We know it should be a 1/2, and it looks very close to 1/2.
Okay. So we've noticed on each of these that this guy that's multiplied by x gives us our change in y versus our change in x. So we just need to figure out what is the change in y versus the change in x. What's the change in y versus the change in x when I move from this point to this point? Backward, I can move from this point to this point. Kind of record what the change in y over the change in x is. And you want to get some of those changes?
The change in y is 3.
Change in y is 3. Is positive 3?
Yeah.
That must mean that you started here.
It's negative 3.
Okay, you start here.
Yeah.
Okay, we would move negative 3. We could start here, but you could move positive 3, right?
Yeah.
You just need to make note of what you're doing exactly. So if we start here and we move vertically towards this point, we move down 3.
Mm-hmm.
And the horizontal change?
5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's important that you move from one point to another in a particular order and note the vertical and horizontal change that you take. So you take a negative 3 horizontal and a negative 3 vertical and a positive 5 horizontal. If I go from here, then I get a positive 3 vertical change and a negative 5 horizontal change. Okay? Those two things are equal to each other. They're both equal to the number negative 3/5.
So the number with vertical change always goes to the top?
Yes, the vertical change is always in the numerator. Okay. Another question? Let's see. Just a quick review here. What kind of slope does this have?
0.
It has a 0 slope. What is this?
Undefined.
Let's talk about the changes again. Right? Undefined. So you've got a 0 slope. Here you have an undefined slope. Okay. The reason this is 0 is because we just look at the vertical over the horizontal change. From this point to this point, what's the vertical change?
0.
None.
So our vertical change is 0. Our horizontal change, our change in x, is how much? Anything, it doesn't matter. It could be 2, 3, 4, 5, negative, whatever, 0.723. It's still 0 divided by that thing. And 0 divided by anything is?
0.
0. Okay. Here, we get kind of the flip-flop of that. We get a vertical change of it doesn't matter because we have a horizontal change of nothing. Okay? And that, long story short, you can't divide by 0. There is no sense to be made of dividing by 0. There's no definition for that. Right. We talked about how weird that would be if we saw the water fill the those different canisters in that kind of a way. It's just so we would have to take on all the heights at one instant in 0 seconds. It would have to have, it would have every height of water possible. It's just not possible. You just can't do that. That. Are you guys ready to? I just want you to graph the line for me. Can you do that?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's clear our desks and do that. All right. So what would be a point? It would be very easy to find. Even 0, 2. 0, 2. With 0 there, there's nothing. +2, nothing. +2 is 2. Zero, two.
Plus me. Oh, well, I got one.
Be careful. Don't get your... Make sure you don't get your X's and Y's backwards, that you don't put this point over here at 2, 0.
Later on.
0, 2. Okay. Ethan, go for it.
4, negative 1.
4, negative 1. Okay. Ethan, did you just follow the slope on down, or did you do the math?
I did the math.
You did the math? Okay, so you did negative 3/4 times 4 over 1 plus 2. Four divided by 4 is 1, so you have negative 3 times 1, negative 3 plus 2 equals negative 1. There we go. But also, it is okay. You don't want to forget that this is how you can be sure you're correct about this, but hey, every 4 X's you go over, you lose 3 Y's. You go down 3. It's like losing 3
cookies.
Because your
deer.
Butter came.
Sure, you're eating. You're
eating
3 deer. You're eating 3 cookies.
3 calories.
Every 4 minutes.
Jeez.
Losing 3 calories every 4 minutes.
Oh,
that's not, those two
awesome.
Don't go together. You can't eat cookies and lose 3 calories every 4
minutes.
Lose 3 pounds every 4 weeks. That's a good example, too. Lose 3 pounds every 4 weeks. Okay, it's going down. Every 4 weeks that go by, you lose 3 pounds. Right? You start at 2 pounds. You start at 2 pounds, then you go 4 weeks down the road, you lose 3, now you float.
And you're
negative 1 pound. Okay, there's our line. Good, good job. Any questions?
Straight lines.
Yeah, quality. That's what we strive for here. Okay, then let's have our notes out. Or rather, we should have already had them out. That's all right. Alright. Okay, already passed into reviews. We do just have a few problems, which means should tell you we don't have a whole lot to learn here. Okay, part of the reasoning there is tomorrow we have a catch-up day. So the end of the quarter is on Friday. Which means tomorrow you should plan on maybe making up some homework, maybe retaking a test, or taking a test you have not yet taken, or finishing a test that you started but didn't finish. Thursday is maths testing, okay? And Friday is the end of the quarter. Bridger?
Two questions. First, are we doing maths testing both days?
As far as I know, just Thursday.
And then also...
I might be wrong. Let me, I don't know, I'll double check.
And then for catch-up day, will you be putting on the board any extra credit?
Will I be putting extra credit on the board on catch-up day?
Yeah, like if we caught up on everything.
Oh, no? But you can catch up in other classes?
Are you expecting us to finish the math test in one day?
No, he just said it all. Okay,
I don't
question? So can I take retake on the test tomorrow?
Yes, you can do lots of things tomorrow on that makeup day. All right, let's move on.
Mr. Stewart.
Oh, yes?
So I'm going to be gone Thursday and Friday.
Uh-huh.
So when should I call the makeup day?
You'll have to talk to one of the counselors, I think, to get that.
We should call you when you're not.
Yeah, they'll take care. I don't take care of that at all.
All
right. So. Here we are. We have a line. Shouldn't take long. Feels like it's going to take longer than it needs to because it's a bit noisy in here. Here's our line. I've shown you 2 points. We know what the slope is. It's a vertical change versus a horizontal change. Can you tell me what the slope of this line is by looking at it? Take a second in your notes and see if you can determine what the slope of that line is. I know it's kind of far away. Those dots are kind of light. Take a second.
How did it jump?
7/4.
4/7.
4/7.
4/7.
4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7. 4/7.
4/7.
4/7.
4/7.
4/7. 4/7. 4/7. I've heard 4 over 7, I've heard negative things, I've heard 7 over 4.
It's 7 over 4.
No, 4 to 7, 4 to 7.
Now we changed our mind to 4 over 7. How many vote for we agree with 4 over 7? Okay, sounds like a strong majority.
Yep.
I have a question.
Yes. Yes.
So you go ahead and you take the X Y. How do you know which one you should take away from which one?
It won't matter.
Oh, you just don't have to count the negatives.
No, we always count negatives if they're negative. Let me show you. Let's start here and count our vertical change up towards this point. So we go up 1, 2, 3, 4. Right now we are level horizontally with that point. Okay. So that's a positive 4. And then we move which direction?
Right.
To the right. Let's all agree it's 7. So we have a positive 7. But let's start at this point. If I move from this point to this point, I have to move vertically which direction?
To the left.
Vertically. Vertical is up and down. So we have to move a negative 4, right?
Yeah.
Down 4. So that's a negative 4 or a vertical change. And when we move horizontally, which way do we have to move?
Negative 7.
To the left 7. To the left 7, so that's a negative 7. So we have negative 4 over negative 7, which the negative divided by negative is?
Positive.
So it's the same as a positive 4 over positive
7. Gosh, I'm so amazing.
Yes.
Well, I did that the other way, where I took like the coordinates and like minus from each other.
Okay, let's talk about that. Now we can just like count it off, count up and over or down and to the left. Please stop playing with your phones. I'm going to go in jail very soon. Oh, they know who they are. So let's look at this problem. Oh no. I erased the points. Okay, now let's. Let's look at it a little differently. We don't just count it off. Let's see if we can calculate these changes. This is at 3, 2. This one is at 10, 6.
Oh, yeah, come on.
All right. Rather than just counting it off, how can we find, let's say we're going to start here and end up here, like this is the first point and this is the second. How do I figure out, just given the coordinates here, how far it is from here to there? Kyler, standing up, enthusiastic.
You know, I got a great idea. Since it's 3, 2, 10, 6, you can just add on 7 to get 10, plus 4 to get 6. Or you can just subtract 10.
So if I were.
Subtract it right there.
Well, you're right, though. If I were to add on 4 to 2, that would get me to 6. Okay? To turn it into more of a calculation, I could say, well, right here, from here, the x-axis up to there is how far?
6.
How far is it from here to there?
2.
2, right? That part of the point tells us that.
And you could just subtract them.
So we took 6 and subtract the 2, and we're left with the 4.
But
Grace?
Yes.
Okay, for an equation, since it's you do a 10 minus 3 because they're both y.
10 and 3 are both y things?
And 6 minus 2 is.
Yeah,
good, that's
x
what I just said.
6 minus 2 are both y things, 10 minus 3 are both x things.
Yeah.
You just said it.
Yeah.
See, that's
how do you know
I
which
said
one
that
minus
and
from which one?
I got it right, and you just got it
one. No,
it won't matter.
No
as long as you keep the order right, it won't matter.
Oh.
Okay.
The signs will work out just like they did here as we batted it off.
Okay.
So, you're really kind of not helping yourselves out, but I'm going to keep talking. We have this y value minus this y value gives us how far it is from here to there. Okay, so 6 minus 2. Now that I've chosen to take 6 minus 2, I have to be careful. Okay, this is like my ending point, and this is my beginning point, my point number 1 and my point number 2. It doesn't matter which one I call 1 and 2, but once I name them, it needs to stay consistent. Right?
And
I take my ending point, the vertical value of my ending point, and subtract the vertical value of my beginning point. That's 4 from bottom to top. Okay? But horizontally, right, I'm moving from here to there. Right? Horizontally, I have a value of 10. Right? From there to there is 10. From here to there is how far?
4.
3. There to there is 3. So to figure out this horizontal change, well, there's a distance of 10 from there to there. This little bit right here is 3 according to this point. And so from here to there is 10 minus 3. Right, so 4 over 7. Do you think that would work every time at every point?
Sure.
Yeah, right, it would. Let's look at a just generally some points. Okay? Let's say we start with this one and end with this one. It won't matter which one you call the first point and which you call the second point as long as you keep it consistent. Okay? So we established that, okay, so I'm going to move from here up, right, vertically to find the slope, up to where this is.
Yeah.
Right, so we've got from there to there. That's just the y value at this point.
But we don't know what it is.
Point. Right. We don't yet. And if we knew where this point was, we would know how big this y value is, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Right. Right. So we would take this y value minus this y value.
Equals
that
y
there. Y. Equals this y distance. This change. Okay. So let's give it some names. Okay. We're not going to give it specific numbers, but this is point number 2. Every point has an x and a y. Since this. These are the x and y of point 2. We'll call this x 2 and y 2. X 2, y 2. And this is point 1. It has an x and a y value. X 1 we'll call it and y 1. So how far is it from here to there? From here to there. It's vertical.
4. It's 4.
It's the y axis. The x-axis. There are no numbers here. We do not know if it's 4 or 10,000.
Oh, I thought we were still on that same.
How far is it from there to there? Since I don't have a specific number, how do I say it?
A certain amount.
The y value of?
2.
The second point. So which y is that?
2.
The y of the second point, right?
Two.
From here to there, the y of this point here. So y2. How far is it from here to there?
Y1.
Y1, I'll try to squeeze that in there. So to find this this amount, right, this distance, this change, how would I calculate that change?
Subtract
Y1 from Y2. Subtract Y1 from Y2, exactly. This distance is Y2 minus Y1. So as we're looking for our change in Y, we would take the Y of the second point minus the Y of the first point. And as we look for the horizontal change, well, here's a distance here. How far is it from here to there?
X2.
How far is it from here to here? It's the x of the first point.
X1.
And we're looking for this horizontal change.
So x1 minus x2.
Almost. It's x2 minus x1.
Why? How come we can't do it the other way?
The short answer is if you get them mixed up and you do y2 minus y1, but in the denominator you do x1 minus x2, then you're going to get the wrong right numbers, but it's going to be the wrong sign. Okay. Now, if I were to switch it and call this point 2 and this point 1, it wouldn't make any difference. The signs would just kind of work out the way that they need to work out. So, the y of the second point minus the y of the first point, whichever one you call point 1 or point 2, it doesn't matter. Just as long as in the denominator you also have x2 minus x1. And you need the vertical change between point 2 and point 1, and then the horizontal change between point 2 and point 1. Y is vertical, x is horizontal. Here we go. It's a universal formula, if you want, for the slope of any line, the slope between any two points. Will not matter which way we go. Okay? We'll try it here. We already did it the one way. We called this point 1 and point 2. We did y2 minus y1, x6 minus 2, y x2 minus x1, 10 minus 3. We got 4 over 7. Let's see what happens if we call this point 2 and this point 1. Well, we'll just take 2 minus what?
1.
A y1. This is 2, this is y1, which is 6, right?
Yeah.
Okay, well that was 2 minus 6, so we need to count this as our second point. Again, our second point comes first. 3 minus 10. What do we get in the numerator?
4, 7.
What do we get in the denominator?
Negative 7.
Negative 5 by negative, positive. So it also comes out to be 4, 7.
So put that one for oil, right? And then equation, if you have square equation on it.
If I said find the slope between these two points and I gave you some coordinates, that would be a good way to go right there.
Alright.
That would be the way to go.
So you literally should do almost anything to find that out. You can go up, you can do negative, you can do...
Well, almost, but if I switch it up and I do accidentally 6 minus 2, I'm showing you a mistake here, a common mistake. If I do 6 minus 2, but then I do 3 minus 10, and here I got a positive 4, but a negative 7. That's a negative slope. Does this line have a negative slope?
No.
No, negative slopes go down and to the right. This doesn't have a negative slope.
That's why I said almost.
Almost. The thing that you can do anything about is choose your second and first point completely at random. It won't matter. As long as your point 2 is where you find your x1 and x2, or sorry, your x2 and y2. And your point 1 is where you find your x1 and y1. You may have already. Feel free to now start on your homework. I'm going to do one more example here on the board if you like. If you don't mind, I'm about to do another example.
Is it the, do you want to less the problems?
Yeah, just see what 5 problems.
How many do you like?
Even if we have some negative y and x values, still works.
Yeah.
So what I need to do is choose one of these point 1 and point 2. I'll call this one point number 1 and point number 2. So when I do y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, here's my y2 for my point 2. Minus y1, that's minus negative 7. Over x2 is 3. Minus x1 is negative 2. So 5 minus negative 7, how do I subtract a negative 7?
Wait, how do you do that?
Yeah. Subtracting a negative 7 is adding to positive, so we have 7 plus 5. That's 12. 3 minus negative 2, that's 3 plus 2, that's 5. So the slope between these two points is 12 over 5. There you go. One more with negative values.
Because that's negative.